Monster Guys present a Yokai podcast presentation, bringing to life, through short stories and informative discussion, the strange, the beautiful, the whimsical, and the mystery of Japanese Yokai.
Now please enjoy a story about
the Ao Andon, in a story titled The Gathering, written by D.C. McGannon. Narrated by D.C. McGannon, C. Michael McGannon, Cheyenne Zumwalt, and Holly L. McGannon. Presented by The Monster Guys.
It happened as I sat long into my evening meditation. The light of my lamp flickered against the moonlight stretching across my floor, casting an eerily strange hue. Severing the tranquility of an empty mind, I was sure I witnessed the shadows bend, followed by a brief wind of chaos as my lamplight chased its darkness. I felt the skin on my neck tighten, and then give way to the dance of hundreds of tiny hairs across the base of my skull. "What fiendish wind comes to disrupt my peace tonight?" I thought out loud. Before the words finished their roll off my tongue, I knew it would have been better to keep my thoughts to myself. "Damn this night," I whispered, again chastising myself for my inability to contain my words.
"Indeed,"
a voice tripped through the air in the room. "Who's there?" I demanded. "Indeed what?"
"Prophetic utterances,"
came another voice, and then another.
"This night, damned."
"I'm mad. What is this I hear? Show yourself, devils."
"Indeed."
The voice slithered along the far wall. I reached for my lamplight and braced to stand, quickly recoiling as the fire of my lamp became enraged and sent me shuffling for safety. I knew I was not alone in my room. As quickly as my lamplight became a furious burst of flames, it was snuffed into darkness, as if by some unseen hand. Again, the voices came.
"This night, we shall complete your story."
"What story? What do you speak of?"
"Your story, good sir. A story of cruelty and forgiveness."
"Of selfishness and desire."
"The story of your life, and now the final chapter."
"What do you mean? I don't know what you're talking about." In that moment, a single blue lantern sparked to life in the center of my room. With it, the strangest set of eyes, belonging to a short, impish figure, glowered in the firelight.
"In a time not too long ago, you were a hurried man, unconcerned for the goodwill of those around you."
A second blue lamp was lit, barely outlining a tall figure with an unruly mop of hair.
"You were more concerned about your own well-being, rushing here and there, consuming what you must in order to advance your own success."
A third light glowed, then a fourth, both with their own demons.
"There was a woman."
A fifth, held by a skeletal hand.
"She was in need, in pain."
The lanterns continued to flare, one at a time, each with a different devil, a different goblin, in rapid succession.
"She cried out for your help."
"Helpless, in despair."
The room began to cast a blue complexion, haunting, suffocating. "I remember, I know of this woman. I was unkind, lacking grace."
"Your memory serves you well."
"Each day for a week you passed her in the market, unresponsive to her plea."
"But I..."
"Her body was bruised, her mind twisted."
"Her child taken from her."
"All you had to do was listen and help."
"I did. I went back after that week and found her."
"But it was too late."
"I gave her bread."
"But her heart was already broken. Her child sold to pay her debts."
"I tried."
"But it was too late."
"You could have saved her and her child."
"My heart was broken too, after one of the village elders shared her plight with me. I had no idea."
"Because you didn't listen."
"I was wrong, I know. But I went to her and found her as soon as I knew."
"But it was too late."
"I begged for forgiveness. She forgave me."
"Easy for someone who is broken and dying to forgive. Her soul was rent in two."
What else could I have done?
Listened.
Reached out your hand to one so desperately in need.
Instead, you walked on, concerned with your own life.
Greedy. Selfish.
But she forgave me. I'm a changed man.
Yes, you are. And that will gain you a measure of mercy in the time to come.
What do you mean?
You may have received forgiveness and pardon from a dying woman. You have settled your conscience in this life. But your next moments have yet to come.
By this time, 99 lights filled the room where I lay cowering. Lit blue, though the room was, I could not see the details of the 99 monsters all around me. The shroud of fear hung heavy on my shoulders.
You have angered the Ao Andon. She is here to weigh your sins.
It was only what I feared, given the multitude of blue lanterns. The Ao Andon! She's a story for children! A fright for the storyteller to conjure. She's not real. She can't be.
Oh, the blue demon may be a spook for child's play, but be certain of this. She is real, and your story has caught her attention. Tonight, the 100th light and the 100th story is yours.
Just then, the first blue lamp was snuffed out by an unseen wind. Then the second, and the third. Wait, what's happening?
By the light of the 100th flame, you shall pay your recompense.
One by one, the fire of the lamps vanished into streams of incense. Wait, where are you going? Don't leave me here alone.
The woman.
She cried out for you.
You didn't help her.
Her child. Gone now, enslaved by the cruelty of men. The child was all she cared about.
She lived only to care for that child.
You ignored her plea.
I'm sorry.
Now you will make your own plea to the blue demon.
What do I say?
Only what you can.
But help me. Stay with me. Advocate for me.
We have done what we can.
The time has come.
The final light of the blue lamps diminished slowly until all had vanished. A single prayer that remained now floated into the heavens. No! No! I lowered my face into my hands, weeping. Somebody please help me. I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to be so selfish. If only I had known. I heard the crackle of a wick being lit. Wiping my eyes, I raised my head, filled with sorrow, and there before me, illuminated with the fire of 100 candles, the blue demon gazed deep into my soul, awake, her eyes lit with blue fire. Though whether an angry spirit or simply curious, I could not tell. I knew she was hungry for the final part of my story. Was I to tell it, or was she? Fearful and trembling, I remained speechless, though my heart cried out for mercy. I closed my eyes, and the blue light of the Ao Andon gave way to the darkness of the night.
The Ao Andon, or the Blue Lantern Demon, is a really cool monster. I think for me, it is a ghost story to end all ghost stories, because it's literally a bunch of people getting together to tell a ghost story in order to create a ghost.
For me, it's one of the more interesting yokai in the whole pantheon of yokai.
Yeah, and I think after our interview with Matthew Meyer, and even Zach Davison talked about it as well, I had seen the Ao Andon around before, but it had never really caught on what exactly the Ao Andon was about. So just having this almost like a Bloody Mary ritual, but instead of standing in front of the mirror and doing it yourself, you know, having a bunch of friends around and playing this game to get through 100 different ghost stories, that's pretty darn cool.
Yeah, it does sound like a lot of fun. And Matthew Meyer's interview is actually what piqued my interest much higher about this yokai. So thanks, Matthew. It was part of a ghost storytelling party called the Hayako Monogatari Karankai. And interestingly enough, I think there are still a lot of people that try to replicate that party and try to play that out, even if it's like a party game versus trying to actually conjure the demon, but kind of an interesting game.
You said replicate. I'm just amazed that you could actually replicate the name.
Well,
that's
I tried.
A fun name.
It is a fun name.
I'm not going to try.
I've tried several times. I hope it came out right. If I didn't, somebody I'm sure will crucify me. It's fun to say if you can get it right.
It is fun to say. It's fun to listen to. But yeah, this is a really cool. I kind of would like to take part in one of these. You still see it in manga and anime.
Mm-hmm.
To this day, you see different incarnations of the Blue Lantern Demon and the game that's associated with her show up in different stories. And that's pretty cool that you have these different facets of yokai that survive and thrive in this modern day and age.
And it's very cool because this is a yokai that is not created by natural things. Mm-hmm. It's not a part of the natural world. It's a creature that's created by way of telling these ghost stories. But she has some very specific features, some that are rooted in the history, especially of Japan, but the history of the world in terms of beauty and appearance. And tell us a little bit about her appearance, because it's a fascinating study all to itself.
Well, a lot of other female yokai are either beautiful or they're monstrous to look at, or they switch between the two. She is monstrous to look at and eerie because of the blue light that the lanterns, which themselves, the lanterns that they use in this game are blue, which is pretty
cool.
It's
fascinating that they use the color blue for this.
To create that eerie, crazy atmosphere. But she did have black teeth. And we were talking about this earlier.
Yeah, that's just so strange to me. And you were telling me the history of that, the black teeth.
Yeah, it's actually, it was a beauty standard for different reasons, depending on what period of time it was a thing and what part of Asia that you were, you know, practicing this in. But women would actually... Men would do this as well, but mostly...
Mostly women.
Yeah, mostly women would paint their teeth black as a beauty standard. And I guess it even had a purpose at some point as well, preventing tooth decay. But to be honest, I don't know the full background of why they would do it, other than, you know, black was a rich color. It was something that was beautiful to look at.
The black lacquered look.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just so strange to me that you would dye your teeth black as a beauty standard, because the other part of that was a lot of times they would pluck their eyebrows. They would do all kinds of very strange, you know, and today we'd almost think of that as some
body
kind of strange, strange rock star, but, but it was a beauty standard and it was highly looked upon.
I guess it's less extreme beauty modification or body modifications, but
I guess.
Yeah, there were actually several yokai that had black teeth. There's actually one that's kind of like the Nipiribo, that her name means nothing but black teeth.
Yeah, it is a yokai that is the black teeth.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But several yokai across the board, and growing up and reading about different monsters and different Japanese yokai, I always thought it was kind of eerie and spooky that these different female spirits had specifically black teeth. And back then, I thought it was because, you know, their teeth were rotten or something. It's not. It was actually based on people, like real people around that time. And I have to wonder, does it make them less scary or more scary to people who know about that practice?
Yeah, I don't know. So the Ao Andon, she is a yokai that is created by storytelling.
Yeah, a fabular creature.
A fabular creature. People gather together. The game goes as such. You tell 100 stories. At the 100th story, she's supposed to appear. However, most people never get to see her and have no idea what she would do if she would appear, because they're too afraid to go past 99 stories. You know, it's kind of one of those party games. You want the creature to show up in the mirror so bad, but once you get to the mirror, you don't want to do it for fear of what you're going to find there.
I, for one, never did that.
And so it's a really fascinating study in yokai, the Ao Andon.
Yeah, and I, again, would like to take part in this at some point. Maybe, I don't know, maybe to go over to Japan or try to...
Yeah, aren't you concerned what you're going to find?
You know, I don't want to do Bloody Mary in the mirror, but it maybe would be fun to, if I'm going to go out by way of monster, might as well do it by telling stories.
Might as well tell stories, and it might as well be the Ao Andon. Well, our story tonight, an original tale that we wrote and narrated, kind of flips the script a little bit, because it's about a guy who has the yokai light the candles and then reverse the process of the storytelling game on him. So there's an interesting twist there. I hope it was an interesting story to people.
I liked it. But that's the thing about fabular creatures. they change depending on the story and who's telling it. So I thought it was appropriate.
Yeah, so the Ao Andon, another wonderful yokai to look into. If you don't know about it or want to go deeper, we encourage you to start at yokai.com. Matthew Meyer's blog and write-ups about the yokai. And of course, you can find her in so many different locations. And it's just a fun look into yokai lore. As always, you can find us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Just look us up, The Monster Guys. Leave us some love. Subscribe on iTunes. We love to hear from you. And until next week, we bid you good night.
Good night.